What is up, YouTube? Today, one of the happiest days that you guys been waiting for, especially for the Apple fans. You won't get too much disappointed. Now, this is the full, honest review, guys. I'm not sponsored with any company or anything, so this is going to be a full, truthful video on the iPhone 5, whether you should buy it, whether you should stick around with it, and whether you should stick it in your pocket for 2 years with a contract, or whether you should ditch your iPhone 4S just for this phone. Alright, first of all, the design is similar to the 4S, however, there are some minor differences. As usual, we have white and black colors. Now, it is 18% thinner, which makes a pretty decent difference, because the iPhone 4S was not really thick, actually, and compared to the 4S, if this is even more thinner, wow. Pretty impressive. Alright, and it's 20% lighter. Now that's really important because the previous iPhones, they had that heavy glass both in the front panel and back panel, which made it kind of uncomfortable when you hold it for a while. Now over here we have a 4-inch Retina display. Now guys, I'm not joking, but the Retina display for Apple, it is beyond amazing. The resolution is 1136 by 640. 18% more than the iPhone 4S. Now it is widescreen. Finally, Apple has decided to choose that kind of display instead of 9 inches and kind of awkward display where you had to double tap to zoom in and it would be just too big. Now it's just widescreen. You got all of the video formats available. Alright, now ultra fast wireless. It is actually dual band wireless, which makes it extremely fast and comes with LTE. Now, the iPhone 4S, people thought it would come with LTE, but sadly it did not. Finally, we have the iPhone 5 with LTE. Over here, it's just giving you a basic speed demographic about it, etc. Okay, and it has an A6 chip processor. That is extremely fast because compared to the iPad 3, really decent. I'm sure this is going to be really, really fast. And surprisingly, the hours are really decent for LTE. As you can see, 8 hours for LTE browsing. That's not normal, guys. That's extraordinary. That's really nice. And we have the redesigned earphones. Now, Apple has been thinking about this for almost 3 years, and finally, they actually released it. One of the things that I do not like is they actually put the 3.5mm head jack at the bottom. Not really useful. I would say it kind of gets in the way a lot, but for some people it might not. We have an EyeSight camera that is, it's 8 megapixel camera, and now they added some features such as the panorama. You can just kind of glide your iPhone and take a long picture. Enhanced HD video recording, now 1080p video recording, video stabilization, face detection for up to 10 faces. Really nice. And now, here's one of the biggest things I would say that you must have in your phone, a FaceTime HD camera. As you all are aware, first time FaceTime came, it wasn't HD on the iPhone, neither the iPod or the iPad. It was like less than 1 megapixel. Now this is 720p HD. Other than that, we have the charger dock connector, which is 18-pin instead of 30-pin, which was really, really similar to the leaks, and probably exact same thing, I would say. So it's lighter, smaller, and smartable. Oh yeah, and it is reversible. So if you have trouble connecting your iPhone at night, don't know which side it is, it's not going to be a problem anymore. Now you have a take a turn for the better. Now that's a really nice feature for the iPhone. You actually have turn-by-turn directions, GPS integrated. One thing I don't like about is if you're mainly going to use it for navigation, that's alright. But if basically you just want to kind of load maps and check out the new 3D maps, it's a bit slow, I would say. Not really fast on that. Alright, now we have the Siri. Okay, I'll be honest, Siri, it's not really that useful unless you just basically want to use it a lot, or I wouldn't say really that people use it. I mean, it's kind of easier instead of pressing and holding a button for 2 seconds, then opening an app, and it'll take 2 seconds just to open. Other than that, you can just swipe and click. You got your app right there. So basically, they just added a feature where you can launch apps from Siri. Not bad, but the iOS 6, the world's most advanced mobile operating system. However, I totally do not agree with that. I wouldn't say it's the world's most, but they have added quite a lot of features. Now, cloud. As usual, people have cloud. It's been here for a while. Nothing that much other than that. Now we're going to check out the design. Alright, so as you can see, they have a aluminum back, which is completely black except for the top, which is a two-shaded top, I guess. 7.6 milliliters, 112 weight. That's the weight of it in grams, and 3.31 volume inches. They say it's our thinnest display ever. I would agree on that because actually it is pretty neat how they made it pretty thin. Especially with the 4G and LTE in it. Nice, I would say. I like the design, I have to say. Design is really nice. However, the internal functions kind of upset me a little bit, but I mean, iPhone is going to come up with way more other technologies like iPhone 6, 7. They got a line ahead of them. So over here we have a sapphire crystal coating or a glass. So it's like scratch resistant. You don't really usually scratch your camera. And it's diamond cut beveled edge. Wow, that's really nice. So it's saying that it used a crystalline diamond to cut the chamfers of the iPhone 5. Really nice. We got the same earbuds. Here's the back, what it looks like. I would say it's very similar to the iPhone 5. But if you really, really want to change, that's just totally up to you guys. Alright, let's check out the features. The 16GB is for $199. The 32GB is for $299. And the 64GB is for $399. Now, it weighs only 3.95 ounces. And it's only 4.87 inches tall. Not bad. It has GSM models, CDMA model, and Bluetooth 4.0. Alright, it has assisted GPS, a digital compass, Wi-Fi, and cellular. Now, it has a Retina display, as I mentioned earlier. And what's interesting about it has a fingerprint resistant, which is really odd for iPhone because they usually have a lot of fingerprints on the screen. 8 megapixel camera, panorama, video recording, HD, and yeah, that was just a truck that just backed up. Anyway, improved video stabilization. And other stuff that you can go check out on Apple's website. Now here comes to the main point. Guys, if you have an iPhone 3G, 3GS, or 4, I would definitely recommend to get the iPhone 5. However, now if you have the 4S, please, guys, don't make this mistake. Don't get it. It's not going to be really worth it. Because we have three major phones that are coming up. One, the iPhone 5, which is already out almost. The Galaxy Note 2 and the Windows Nokia Lumia 920. Now, I would recommend not to pre-order it as fast as you can. Just kind of wait, explore the Note 2. I mean, the Galaxy Note, it is awesome. I mean, beyond awesome, the one. So I'm pretty sure the Galaxy Note 2 is going to be pretty awesome. So yeah, guys, I wouldn't recommend really pre-ordering it unless you had an iPhone 4 or older. I would definitely recommend you to go for it. So yeah, guys, thank you, and please comment, like, and subscribe.